Some people think that because we have a motor, we can tackle the longest, tallest, and steepest hills in the world, but that is simply untrue. However, there are many factors that affect our ability to tackle climb, such things as rider weight, ground conditions, bike geometry, and of course, rider skill. But there's one thing that is often overlooked, and that is gearing on your e-bike. Now, e-bikes come with a vast array of gearing that's dependent on the manufacturer and the motor you have on your e-bike. For example, our Specialized Levo here has a 32 tooth front chainring and a 1042 cassette on the back. At the same time, the Yamaha bikes we have on EMBN have 38 tooth front sprockets and 1046 cassette on the back. At the same time, our high bike we have here, the Xduro 10, actually has a much smaller front sprocket, in this instance a 16 tooth front sprocket. So if you think about it, a lot of the time the mountain bike industry relies a lot upon gearing as a major upgrade part of that industry, and because the front sprocket on this Bosch bike is about $15.99, it's a really simple and inexpensive way to change your gearing. Now today we're going to be focusing just on the Bosch motor and the gearing on this high bike, because it's actually quite different to the other bikes out there. Bosch run a much smaller sprocket up front compared to, say, the Yamaha, Shimano, Specialized and Bro systems, and you can actually do it quite inexpensively, as I mentioned earlier. Now what's interesting is that this year particularly, lots of brands have changed from a 16 tooth front sprocket — there's actually a 16 tooth on this bike — down to, say, 15 tooth up front, and with the addition of, like, say, NX Eagle, people are now running like a 1050 cassette at the back. But what you've got to remember is, if you change one tooth up front, it's equivalent to about two or three at the back. So today we're going to be swapping between a 16, 15 and 14 front sprockets to see the difference and the effect it has on the ability to climb an e-bike. Crikey. Watch that, it's a bit steep there. Wow, it is a bit steep actually. Okay, so I'm 5 minutes into the climb. This is the critical part. The trail turns. I'm in 1642. Oh, crikey. As you can see, no way in a million years am I getting up there. 1642, no chance. Ooh, coming in, this feels a bit easier. I'm now in 1648 on the Bosch system. It's spinning a lot easier, 1648. Yeah, way easier. But, oh my God. It's just not quite doable in a 1648. Let's get up the van and swap it out to a 14 and see what effect that has. Okay folks, I just want to point out that we are actually focusing solely on the Bosch system on this video today. And if you do decide to go and get some smaller chain rings, there's a few things to bear in mind if you do it. The chain rings are available in 14 to 22, but if you do buy the single only chain ring, don't forget that usually there's going to be a bash guard that's going to come off that motor, so you need to have a substitute bash guard to go back with the chainring when you're going to be replacing it. You'll also need a lock ring tool to get the lock ring off, obviously, and that's also going to come in handy when you tighten back up the bash ring onto that front sprocket. So why then would you want to change the gearing on your e-bike? Maybe it's fine as it is, but if you want to go for a lower gear, that may be because you live in possibly a wetter climate where you're going to need to be spinning the pedals more, and generally because of the heavy conditions, you simply don't need the higher gear. It could be because the terrain you ride is a lot steeper, a lot more technical, and you simply don't ride fire roads or tarmac roads on your e-bike ride. At the same time, you might want to go for a higher gear on your e-bike, and such people that want higher gears, maybe you're going to be riding non-technical climbs, more fire roads, more tarmac roads. But what I will say is that in that situation, you might be actually getting to the 25 kilometer an hour restriction far easier. So But yeah, there's lots to explore here. But one of the key things, I think, when it comes to gearing is if you do go for a lower gear, that really means that you're going to be conserving the battery on your bike, because on hill climbs, you can be switching the bike into eco or trail mode far more often than riding turbo mode. So that's going to have a huge impact on the battery life on your e-bike. Now, I didn't mention earlier, we're actually running turbo mode on all these hill climbs. So here I am, 14:42, and I can feel that I'm already going to make this bank for the first time ever, even with a slip on the pedals. Yeah, boy! Let's get up there. So the final run, and now I can back off a touch because I know that I can make this bank. So here we are, 14:48. You can see I'm spinning a lot more easy. I can add a little bit of pressure to the cranks to just get me up that climb. Different technique. So there's the four hill climb challenges done, and it simply brings back home to me how much I absolutely love e-biking and the mysteries that they bring up every single day when we're out filming. However, we have the results in, and I can tell you that they really are not what we expected. The first runs were done with a 16 tooth front sprocket. So first up, I was in 16:42 on the back, and obviously I could not get up the hill climb. Remember, we're in turbo mode for all these hill climbs. The second run, 16 tooth up front, 48 tooth on the rear, just about couldn't manage to get up that hill climb. So we went back, had a bite to eat, swapped out to a 14 tooth front sprocket. The first run was 14 up front, 42 in the rear, and by God, it was up, went up there, absolute dream. It was an easy hill climb. So what we didn't show you on that first, on the first run there when we were in 14:48 is that I actually didn't get up the hill in the actually lowest gear possible. So it asked so many questions, and the questions are, it's not just about gearing on the e-bike. It's about loads of other things as well. Things such as your tire choice. Now I know I've rattled on about tire choice a million times, but big chunky tires, low pressures, they're always going to get up that hill a lot easier. Rider weight. Now, if you're, you know, I'm 90 odd kilos. If someone was like 50 to 60 kilos, they're going to be much more likely to get up this bank than I am. However, such things as line choice and technique. Technique is really important. And what we didn't show you actually was when we went out and broke all the rules and tried this hill in a different manner. Let's see what happened. Okay, final run. I'm at the bottom of the steepest part of the climb. I'm about to try and break all the mountain bike rules. The suspension is fully open. My seat is fully down, and I'm in 14:48. Let's give it a go. Oh my God, e-bikes are just blinking great. So yeah, we were really surprised that that happened, breaking all the rules, seat down, suspension open. Oh, I just couldn't believe we did that. But what it did prove, and this is really important when it comes to gearing, is that if, say, you're tackling a 10, 15, 20, 30 minute climb, which you might have in the Alps, having that low gear, having that 14:48 option means that you can take a breather and gather yourself before tackling the next part of the climb, because it's quite unlikely when you ride in an e-bike, you're gonna be riding up a flat fire road. E-bikes are all about technical climbs and getting involved with the hills. So there you go, lots to think about. Don't forget all those things I mentioned, technique and line choice being key, obviously. If you wanna see some more e-bike climbing videos, we've done quite a few 1,000 foot deads now. Sylvain Gentoli, World Superbike Champion, check that out, just down over here. Georgia Leslie, 54, 56 kilos, smashed me to pieces on the hill climb. Check that one out there. Leave us your comments below, because I know there's gonna be loads of them in terms of gearing. Give us a thumbs up if you like the video, and yeah, please subscribe to EMBN.